Good morning. Welcome to worship on this God's Work, Our Hands at Sunday. We had a group yesterday go out to Habitat Restore and volunteer there, and all of our volunteer opportunities this day as well. So we look forward to that. Deacon Cora is going to give some instructions at the end of worship for those who are volunteering this morning. Today we continue with our theme of the book of Romans, renew and restore the promises of God. Today looking at love, to be love, and of course tying in God's Work, Our Hands Sunday there. Next week, we kind of fully begin Sunday school and adult education. So the kids will be with Melinda in the fellowship hall. And Deacon Cora and I are leading a discussion on ELCA social statements, having someone come from the ELCA to Rocky Mountain Synod to speak about advocacy and the church's work and involvement in that. So our social statement is church and society. So check out the SPIN or the ELCA website to be able to download that social statement. We'll hear from Benita and then we'll have conversation and discussion after that as well. Melinda is looking for some volunteers to help with kids at Sunday school, just to be able to lead a group, and she'll have everything for you. You kind of just have to show up and lead one of the age groups, but talk with Melinda if you are interested in being able to help on Sunday mornings. Our Ken Carroll concert series is having their next concert, A Night at the Opera, on Saturday, September 30th at 7:30 p.m. So come and join for that great concert here at St. Philip. Habitat for Humanity, there's a new project starting up in Denver on the property of Augustana Lutheran Church, and they are doing a dedication for that project as they kick that off. That'll be on Sunday, September 24th at 1 p.m. So come and join. If you have any questions, talk with Rich or Julie or Deacon Cora. This week also really starts a whole lot of our Bible studies, men's Bible studies and women's Bible studies and family Bible studies. So check out the SPIN, check out our website, which is fully up to date with all of those Bible studies. Literally a Bible study every day from Sunday to Thursday. So you can find something that you can be a part of. The men used to have a men's Bible study on Tuesday nights, and they are opening that up to everyone. So couples or women or just men can come and join. So everyone can come and join for that Bible study. So again, at Tuesday evenings, and that'll be at Paul and Lori Sealander's house. So come and join them for a great Bible study. They're looking at Isaiah. And I know one of the women's groups, I think Wednesday morning women's group, is doing Isaiah as well. No stretching over scriptures this week. They will, Dean Cora will resume that on the 25th. I am doing pub theology at Locavore, so come join me at 6:35 at Locavore. The men's group has their pizza night this Wednesday, so come and join them. I know their theme, they're going to be having a bunch of electric e-bikes here for people to kind of try out and check out and just have discussion on that, so come and join them this Wednesday. That's all the announcements I have, so I invite you to stand as you are able. Greet those around you. Share the peace of Christ as we begin worship this morning.
Jesus, claiming God's love for the lost and the least. Bless God, our voices we speak in your name, sharing the good news of your gospel. God is at work.
I invite you to turn towards the back of the sanctuary at our baptismal font for our confession and forgiveness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained deacon of the Church of Christ, and by God's authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. God, enliven and preserve your church with your perpetual mercy. Without your help, we mortals will fail. Remove far from us everything that is harmful, and lead us toward all that gives life and salvation, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
The reading today is from Romans chapter 13. Owe no one anything except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and any other commandment are summed up in this word, love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no wrong to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfilling of the law. Besides this, you know what time it is, how it is now the moment for you to wake from sleep. For salvation is nearer to us now than when we became believers. The night is far gone, the day is near. Let us then lay aside the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us live honorably as in the day, not in reveling and drunkenness, not in debauchery or licentiousness, not in quarreling and jealousy. Instead, put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to gratify its desires. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
But I invite the kids forward for a children's conversation. Nice. So today is God's work, our hands. Do you know what that means? So we have, it's really two kind of sentences, right? God's work. So God is working in this world, right? God is present with us. God is here. But our hands, right? Whose hands? Yeah, your hands, our hands. So when we do a different, when we work with our hands, and particularly in this day, we are talking about kind of service opportunities. So some will go and clean up the trail. Some will harvest some of our crops out of the garden, which many of them are sent to sharing with Sheridan, our food pantry. People will letters to seeds of the youth that are part of Seeds of South Sudan to words of encouragement. Others will tie blankets for people in Family Promise who either don't have homes or maybe they're going into a home as they leave the program. Putting together flu kits, putting together activity baskets. These are all things that we're just doing today, right? And all of these things benefit other people, often people who are in need or people who need encouragement, right? And we do service all the time, right? So our food bank operates every Thursday. There are people who help out with Family Promise every day of the week and all throughout the world or all throughout our town, not just here at St. Philip, but part of the whole church, all of the churches throughout the country of the ELCA are doing what we are calling God's Work, Our Hands Sunday. So it's a reminder as we use our hands that we are doing God's work, that God is involved and working in us and through us. So as you do service projects this day or you do service projects in the future, you can know that when you are using your hands or maybe your feet or maybe your voice as we sing in our opening hymn, that God is present and God is working in you and through you, using your hands, using your feet, using your voice, using your presence to care for others as we love others. They too can see that God cares for them and loves them. You pray with me? Dear God, we give you thanks for the reminder that as we serve, as we love, as we care for others, that Lord, you are present in us and with us. And truly, it is part of your work that we are doing your work and you are in us through that. So Lord, we thank you for your presence and help us to know that you are there and that we are truly helping someone in need. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thanks for coming up. Grace and peace to you from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. So blessed to be blessed, or loved to love, right? A couple years ago, it was that phrase of blessed to be a blessing. In our reading in Romans, we really see how we have been loved, and we can go out and love others as well. Well, throughout the book of Romans, we've heard about God's love, God's mercy, God's grace for all baptized children of God. How God has blessed us with individual and specific gifts in our lives that have come from God, and that we have the ability to then live that life that God calls us to in community with each other. So we now have that knowledge and that ability to live together, to love one another the way God loves us. Paul said in our reading for today, love does no wrong to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfilling of the law. So he speaks of all of these different, of the Ten Commandments, and looking and really saying that as we love, it's fulfilling the law, because love is following the commandments. If we are living lives of love, we are following the commandments. And Jesus said to the Pharisees in Matthew 22, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and all your soul and with all your mind. This is the greatest and first commandment." And he continues on and says, "The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all of the law and the prophets." Therefore, love is a fulfillment of the law. The first commandment about God, the rest of the commandments about others and being in community with one another, and how love is fulfilling that. Well, within Paul's life, he knew that Jesus was coming back. Jesus promised that he was going to come back again. Well, Paul really thought that Jesus was going to come back in his lifetime. So he was working to tell the Romans, the time is short. You really need to be able to focus on your faith, focus on your relationship with God, knowing that salvation was near. So he encouraged them to wake from sleep and to put on the armor of light, as we heard in our reading. So this means staying away from and laying aside the works of darkness, not reveling and not drunkenness, not in debauchery or licentiousness, not in quarreling or jealousy. But he says, instead, put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provisions for the flesh to gratify its desires. Put on the Lord Jesus Christ, or put on the armor of light. What might that look like? What might it look like to put on Christ? I think part of it is love. Part of it is caring for one another. Part of it is service, serving those who are in need. So one way of putting on Christ is certainly caring for others and doing service work, which is why we do days like this of God's Work, Our Hands Sunday. Why the ELCA said it's so important for us to be involved in works of service. Martin Luther said it's not the good works, the service that we do, that gain us salvation. It's our faith in Christ that gains us salvation, as we have seen throughout this book of Romans as well. But what Luther said is it's our faith that then leads us to do good works. Out of our faith, it is a response to do service, to do good works, to care and love others. So truly, as we serve, we are doing that. And God is present with us and in us as we serve, and present with those who are recipients of our work, of our hands, which we know it truly is God's work in our world. So what service projects or good works have you done throughout your life? What are some things that you have spent time on in response to your faith, in the response to be able to love someone or care for someone or help someone or walk with someone or truly to serve someone? I want you to think about that as I go through this next part. So it made me reflect, what are some of the service projects that I've done throughout my life? And certainly being part of the church kind of naturally puts you into opportunities of service. So in high school, serving at a food bank, or youth mission trips to Tecate, Mexico, of helping to rebuild a school. Taking time in college to go to Biloxi, Mississippi, and do a rebuilding after Hurricane Katrina and cleanup work. Habitat for Humanity projects. And then I think about all the projects that have been done here at St. Philip in the last 11 years that I've been here. Interestingly, on my watch, I got a news notification right before worship started, and it was from a news station that had said 10 years ago was the flooding that occurred throughout Boulder County. And I thought, holy cow, 10 years ago. But in response, our church went and helped out a resident there in Boulder County who was along one of the streams whose land and house got flooded, being able to do a cleanup work there. The number of years that this church has been involved in Family Promise and Holy Hammers with Habitat, or collecting food at donations, to the service projects that we do today. God's Work, Our Hands has been going on for 10 years now. We started with the ELCA when they started it in 2013. And one of the first projects we did was hearing from Michael Clough, who's at that time superintendent of the Sheridan School District, of the need of people who were hungry. So we took food to about 5 different houses for people who were hungry. And the response from that was, we need to do more, right? And that's when our food bank developed into Sharing with Sheridan. 10 years ago, that seed was planted. So the work that we do and the benefit that it has for so many different people. So what projects or service work have you done throughout your life? And how has that affected you? We may not always see the benefits that our work has, and that's not what's important, right? It's the fact that it's God working in our lives and God working and helping others who are in need. We don't have to have that instant gratification in the service work that we do. And I would say most of the times we don't see those benefits, but we trust that those who are going to be receiving that work or receiving the things that we are doing will be blessed by it. So maybe you've been involved with Family Promise or Habitat here at St. Philip, or maybe the Fall Food Drive or the Community Garden, or even financially supporting a ministry or a Good Samaritan Fund, or making prayer shawls, or making dresses for kids in Haiti, or quilts for Lutheran World Relief and ELCA World Hunger, or visiting those who are sick or in the hospital, or giving someone a call. Those are all acts of service where God is truly working through us to care for those who are in need. And we certainly are a blessing to those who are in need. And it's because of God's blessings to us. We're able to love them because of the love that we receive from God as well. So we are loved to be love. So as you go out and do service today, or as you go out and do service in the near future, may you be reminded of what you are doing and how God is working in you and through you to show love and to bless those who are in need. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let us stand and join in singing our hymn of the day, Jesu, Jesu, fill us with your love.
Neighbors we have from you. Kneels at the feet.
to serve the neighbors we have from you. Neighbors are wealthy and poor, varied in color and race. Neighbors are nearby and far away. Jesu, Jesu, fill us with your love. Show us how to serve the neighbors we have from you. These are the ones we will serve. These are the ones we will love. All these are neighbors to us and you. Jesu, Jesu, fill us with your love. Show us how to serve the neighbors we have from you. Kneel at the feet of our friends, silently washing their feet. This is the way we will live with you. Jesu, Jesu, fill us with your love. Show us how to serve the neighbors we have from you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Let us pray together our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. In this bread and in this wine, that Christ comes to us, loving us and blessing us. Come, let us receive him. You may be seated. During communion, we are offering the opportunity to, since we didn't have our traditional offering, to drop your offering into the offering plate. As you come up to communion, it'll be right there, right where the cups are as well, so you can give your tithes and your offerings this morning that way. But at this time, I invite those who are going to receive communion in your chairs, your pews, and those at home to get out your communion at this time. This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. Come, it's ready and all are welcome.
His body the bread, his blood the wine, broken and poured out, all for love. The whole earth trembled, and the veil was torn. Love so amazing, love so amazing.
Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sin. Some from heaven, Jesus Messiah, Lord of joy and the love of the Lord. We are called to be light for the kingdom, to live in the freedom of the city of God. We are called to act with justice. We are called to love tenderly. We are called to serve one another, humbly with God. Come, open your heart, show your mercy to all those in fear. We are called to be hope for the hopeless, so hatred and blindness will be no more. We are called to love tenderly. We are called to serve one another, to walk humbly with God. Sing, sing a new song. Sing of that great day. And all will be one. God will reign, and we'll walk with each other as sisters and brothers, united in love. We are called to act with justice. We are called to love tenderly. We are called to serve one another. Thank you.
for joy and sorrow till we've seen this journey through. Will you let me be your servant? Let me be as Christ to you.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ that strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Holy Jesus, in this meal you have fed and nourished us to work in your beloved world. Send us now, filled with yourself and strengthened by your Spirit, to live your love for others. Amen.
Amen.
Now for our blessing, our celebrating this event today. We are called to proclaim the good news.
God is at work.
This good news is not left in some history long ago or a place far away. In us and through us, God is glorified in our work. When we offer a helping hand, God is praised. When we share our abundance, God is known in the world. In our service today and in our daily lives, let us live out what God has called us to in our baptism.
God,
God who sets forth the law of love, Jesus who fulfills the law for you, and the Spirit through whom you are called to love, bless you this day that you may be God's hands and heart and voice at work in the world. Amen.
Go make a difference, we can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference, we can make a difference. To let the people see the love of God in you and me. We are the light of the world, not to be hidden but be seen. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference, we can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. You're the
reaching out to those in need, the face of God for all to see. We are the spirit of hope. We are the voice of peace. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. So let your love shine on. Let it shine for all to see. Go make a difference in the world. And the Spirit of Christ will be with us as we go. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world.
And before our dismissal, just a couple of announcements about how things are going to work after worship. We will have coffee card available for those who are doing projects. And if you haven't signed up for a project, it's not too late. There is still space. So you can check out the list of opportunities. They're both listed on the whiteboard and then also on the clipboards here on the table here. All the locations of where you're going to meet are in both of those locations as well. So some of them will be in different classrooms. So just look to see what room you're meeting in, and then also a site leader at each of those projects. For those of you who are going to the trail cleanup, you get to make your lunch first, and then you're going to take your lunch with you. For everybody else, you're going to eat after your project. You're not going to take it afterwards. So if you're staying here, lunch comes afterwards. If you're going on the trail cleanup, you get to make your lunch first. If you have any questions, I'll be out in the narthex to answer any questions that you have. But now for our blessing. Go in peace. You are God's hands at work in the world. Thanks be to God.